yeah, then you guys went back, hung out for a bit, and went to the festival that was that night. It's kind of like your autumn festival, and people who were appeared to be entertainers started stabbing the shit out of the crowd. So that was good. And as you guys were running away, you ran back to the inn after having several very directed bolts fired at you guys, and made it back to the inn to meet up with some strange pig-faced creatures that just about nuked you, but did not. And yeah, you managed to kill three of them in total, and you hung their bodies outside the back door and locked down the door. And we are essentially there right now. Hanging out, a couple corpses inside, then a few dead pig guys outside.
We kicked the corpses outside, remember? They're out in the
back. All of them? The human ones too?
I thought we brought all the corpses out and threw them out in the back.
Yeah.
Okay, cool. They're all on a pile in the back then. That works for me.
And Scott got stabbed by a spear.
Alright, so, it's still nighttime. There are a few people on the streets at this point.
Yeah, we were...
No one...
We were getting ready to go into the tavern, because we're all by the door.
Yes, yes, you were. Yeah. And to note, no one has come back to the inn yet. No one that appeared to be staying there, no one that, yeah, no one.
So let's not waste any more time.
All right, so you're at the tavern door. You know it's locked. You saw the guy lock it. But there it is. A wooden tavern door. What would you guys like to do?
Well, are we going to loot this place, and then are we heading out of town tonight, or what's the plan? Are we going to go back up and spend the night at the inn?
I say we stop.
I don't think we want to spend the night.
That's what I'm thinking. Yeah. I think we get some food and provisions and a hell of a lot of mead, and someone should get the carts ready.
All right.
If only we had a stable boy.
If only.
Well, I'll take a close look at the lock. I assume that Animaeus has a key.
I thought we'll try a key, but I think I broke the right key.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Like I'm saying, out of game, but I'll try the one key I have.
Alright, you give the key a try, and no, unfortunately, it's not a fit.
Okay, I'll just bust the door down then.
Okay, well, strength check.
Wait.
But while he's doing that, I'll try to open the door.
Is there a keyhole? Like, you can look through the keyhole?
Yep.
Can I take a peek through that?
Sure.
Where does my foot
stay? Head goes through the door.
you look through the door, or the keyhole in the door. And there are several people in that room.
Can I hear them?
You can hear them kind of whispering to each other, but you can't make out what they're saying. They're definitely talking to one another. All you can really see is kind of guys in some black leather attire.
Oh,
to
shit.
And fro in the room.
I like the place on fire at least.
That's a good idea.
How badly do we need this need?
Just light it on fire.
You just light the fucking whole inn on fire.
Light it on fire and leave.
Yeah, I see you, Antonius. You want to do it. You evil piece of shit.
Wait outside in case anyone tries to escape.
You still want to boot the door down? These guys are probably going to be stabby.
I'm just holding out my flint and steel, and I'm just making sparks go, and I'm heading out the back door along the way as I'm doing it.
Okay. Alright. So, Maple's lighting the place on fire, is that what I'm saying?
Yep.
Okay. I'll try to pick the door open. So, Maple, the walls and stuff are not really catching on fire. I mean, yeah, they're wood planks, but they're not really catching from the sparks. However, some of the cloth drapery that's on the walls definitely is. So things are starting to burn. As you're heading towards the back door.
I got a 7.
Alright. Unfortunately, the lock is too complex.
I will look to you, Yamlokar, and I'll, like, say, kick it in, and come back out of the way so I can go in, because I look like one of them.
Okay.
I'll get them, I'll tell them you guys ran out the back, and then you ambush them.
Okay. Like should we, I'll see if I can get Meeple's attention, like, back.
Oh no, she's gone.
She's already heading to the back, right?
Yeah, she's grabbing the carts.
Okay, I'll roll my strength check here.
Okay.
And so, of course, as soon as I kick the door in, I'm going to get off to the side and then get my weapon ready.
Yeah, okay. I'll hide to the right of the door.
That would be 19.
Alright, you boot in that door and step back. The door flies off its hinges and just crashes to the ground, slides a little bit. Antimaeus, you immediately see three guys inside. They're all looking a little stunned. A couple of them were sitting down. They stand up.
I bust in like an athlete.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yell at them. They're getting out the back. They're getting out the back. Get up.
Okay. Can you give me a deception or whatever the 5e equivalent is? If you don't have that, just charisma, please.
I rolled a 14.
Alright. Yeah, they follow no problem. So they just run past you, run out the doors, or the door.
I'm gonna run behind them so I can stab the last guy when we get outside.
Okay. So, Elmagard, did you head to the back, or were you standing outside the door?
Kind of right beside. As soon as I kicked the door in, I just went right to the side.
Okay, and so Pi is on the opposite side. Okay, yeah. Awesome. Alright, so you guys hear Antimaeus yell this, and three guys start running on out that door. What are you gonna do?
Cut them down.
I'm guessing I'll be closer, because I'm right on this side of the door, right, the open side of her.
Yep.
So I'm actually gonna hit the guy in the middle, the second guy that comes through.
Alright, sounds good. So Pi, you'll go for the first.
Yep.
Amagar for the second. Antimaeus up for the third.
Okay. Up the rear!
Yeah, up the rear. Alright, you guys can each give me advantage on your attacks, too.
Oh, nice. So 20.
Alright, that's definitely a hit. Damage.
What does advantage aid you or help you when you roll a 1?
Well, luckily, advantage is you get to roll two rolls and you take the better, so hopefully your second roll is not a 1.
Oh, okay.
So that's what it'll do.
Even a 2.
Even a 2.
13 damage.
Alright. Yeah, you cut the guy, you just hack him down, he falls to the ground, slides a little bit.
21, so that's a little better, I think.
Yeah, just a little bit. Yeah, it's like 20 or so better.
Yeah.
Oh! 15 damage!
Alright, you hack that guy apart as well. Okay, so two are down, Antimaeus. Follow up with the third.
Just a quick question. If you do get, like, so I did 20 for my hit.
Yep.
And then 12 damage. If that's gonna kill someone, is there any ability to, like, tone it down or anything to, like, keep them alive? Or just, like, describe it as in you probably broke his neck or something and then you keep them alive for 5 seconds afterwards type thing?
Yeah, theoretically you can,
Or, like, get the knife in where you like, snap his kidney and then pull it out at the end?
So, it takes skill to hurt somebody enough to disable them and not knock them out. It doesn't really take skill to knock somebody out, so it depends on whether or not you want them to be conscious, I guess. It's definitely enough damage to knock them out and have them still be alive.
Can I do the whole, like, stab him in the kidney and hold a blade to his throat?
Yeah, you'll have to, you can give me a... Yeah, if you have medicine, that's probably a good applicable.
I don't have it, but I'll just do wisdom, I guess.
Okay. Or intelligence. If your intelligence is higher, do that instead.
Well, they're the same, so 21.
Okay, yeah. Definitely. You stab the guy in a place where you know it will be fatal when the blood comes out, but not while it's in there.
Brilliant.
and but the pain causes him to drop his weapon, so he's stunned, essentially.
Okay. I'm gonna, like, whisper into his ear. Who do you work for?
Do you wanna give me a charisma check?
So that's a five.
Ah, nice.
So I maybe got a little too close to his ear and started linking it or something.
Are you from business?
I hope it's pleasure. So he kind of just looks at you and gives you this kind of glare, but then his eyes roll up into his head as he to the pain just overwhelms him.
I'll let him die then.
Alright, you withdraw your weapon and blood pours, the guy's collapses to the ground. It's starting to get a little smoky in here. Some of the cloth and drapery that's on the wall that it was starting to burn has now really caught, and it's starting to spread to some of the wood pieces of the hall as well.
Okay, someone will check these bodies, and I'll run in and see what I can grab out of the back for food.
Cool. Alright, Almagar, you're rushing in. I'll check bodies.
Pie, save the beer. Save the ale.
Is there
another door, like, in the back room or somewhere that leads outside, or?
There might be.
Well, I guess I'll find out when I get.
Okay, sorry, do you have a question too, Pi?
Zena answered it for me. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Alright. Yeah, I guess I'll scrounge up as much booze and look for some healer kits and whatever. Just good stuff.
Okay. Alright. Cool. So you should run to the back. There are several casks of various ale. It does appear just to be kind of a cellar room behind the bar. It doesn't look like it's way out, unfortunately. That said, there are various sized casks, depending on what you think you might want to carry. And then there's also a big rack of meat, essentially hanging from a big hook in kind of this probably not nearly cold enough room for meat to be hanging. And there's also, like, a couple crates that have, like, some cheese and fruit and that sort of thing in them.
Okay. Well, I guess I can only take one out, huh? They're probably pretty heavy.
Yeah, so there's, like, casks that are, like, this big. You could probably put one under each arm. Or there's, like, ones that are, like, this big, which, I mean, if I guess you're strong enough, maybe you could carry one under each arm, but probably unlikely.
Could I take,
Feed that to the barbarians.
Alright, so what do you guys want to take out of here?
Can I take a cask and a crate?
Crates are pretty large. They have bags in them, though. You can take, like, one of the sacks of the crate. Or you can try and drag the crate and take the cask.
Well, I'm sure between the two of us, we could probably both carry a crate and maybe put extra stuff in it.
You could do that, too.
Okay, yeah, do that, then.
We each grab one end of a crate. You should be able to stack it up pretty good.
All right.
Once we get to the cart, it'll be good to go.
Okay, so you take a crate. I'm assuming you're looking for a crate again that has some cheese and fruit and stuff in it.
Yeah.
And then you're able to fit, like, two of the kind of medium-sized casks on top of it and balance that and still carry it.
There we go.
Awesome.
All right, cool. So you guys are, like, out of there.
Back.
Billion's getting a little smoky now. And to me, as you said, you're searching the bodies. Anything special you're doing with the search or just, like, a standard pat-down?
How close am I to the front door?
Fairly close. So essentially the way this place is organized, you go through the front door, and then, like, 6 feet to the right is the door to the tavern. So they came through that door and died, so they're kind of in the main area there.
I feel confident enough that I can drag all three bodies outside.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And then I'll do that.
Okay.
And then I'll search them, because then I'm outside.
You, as you're out there taking stuff off these guys, you're gonna hear, like, a little bit of screaming kind of down one of the streets, and you start to hear, like, a few shouts from various people and that sort of thing, too, as you're searching these bodies. And by shouts, I don't necessarily mean there's some scared ones, but there's also some commanding kind of ones, too. Alright, in total you get 4 gold. These guys are rich, apparently. 4 silver. And 7 copper.
I'll start taking off, like, swords and ammunition as well.
Okay.
If they have any.
Yeah. Two of them have quarrels that have 10 bolts apiece in them. The same two guys, their crossbows are still inside. But they did have crossbows if you want them. They're light crossbows, and then, the other, or for the rest of the weapons, you can find two daggers, and then, three short swords, if you want any of those.
I brought the horses around from the back yet?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. So you're coming around while he's mid-search.
Okay.
I'm assuming you're coming around to the front, right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, no, so you get around there mid-search, so he's still pulling some things off bodies, you get there, and, shortly thereafter, Almagar and, Pythagoras come out the front door holding a crate with a couple casks on top of it, too.
I'll help them with that, get everything loaded.
Alright,
secure
so
fast,
and then,
yeah.
Alright,
is there any other horses in the back there, Mabel?
There was one other horse back there. It wasn't in great shape, so I'm not sure if you want it or not. But it wasn't.
Because it's just some meat. Now we got enough food, I'm sure.
Yeah, so you guys just call on that one. But it definitely wasn't a traveling horse. It was kind of like probably a some kind of farm horse that's nearing its end.
I would have left it. If it didn't look like it was somewhat profitable. At least right now.
I hope you at least took all of its hay.
Well, we already stocked up on feed.
Did you find paint back there?
I thought we already stocked up on feed and stuff in the market.
Yeah,
I figured we were good on that.
Alright.
Did you have a pig with you, Mabel?
No.
However, you did notice that Peg looks like he had some kind of a choking fit out back.
Oh, wow.
Unless you did something with the body, I can't remember. Or, but I don't think you did. Yeah, maybe he was just eating too quickly or something.
Didn't really pay attention, no. I was busy getting the horses. Didn't see him.
Pig guy's
driving hard out, and just like, dud. Oh,
That's totally Maple right there. really need to clean.
Alright, so as you guys are getting
up,
the wagon loaded up, you hear the shutters across the street in a tall building slide open really quickly. Two shots are taken. Both of them miss you, Antimaeus. Yours is slim. But yeah, you can see a couple people that, again, popped out of those windows to take a couple shots. They ducked back into the window after they took them. You can hear some commotion from inside that building.
I would like to disengage and hide.
I'd say now that we're in the cart, we should try to cover up as much as possible and get the fuck out of here.
Are we going, or...?
Yeah, let's go.
Alright.
Get it, the fuzz! Run!
Who's driving this thing? Out of curiosity.
I will.
Oh, so that they'll be out in the open, right? Shit. There's gotta be something in here, even a hay bale. Let's go throw it on my back. No.
Alright, so, Antimaeus, are you hiding in the cart? Are you hiding somewhere else?
No, I'll hide, like,
under it.
No, I'm not. I don't know that they're just in a ditch, so I'm gonna hide off to the side, hoping that these guys are gonna come out of an alley or something and I can pop them off with a shot.
Okay. Alright, so as you get into the alley...
You don't want to light that building on fire before we leave?
I'm with you.
It's easy enough.
The wagon starts starts to move. And after a few moments, a couple guys do pop back into the windows again with their crossbows loaded. So do you want to try and take a shot at them?
Yes, I do.
Okay, go for it. Now, are you shooting with your normal bow? I think you have a normal bow, right?
No, I'm shooting with one of the crossbows I stole.
Okay, alright.
So I think it's just my normal...
Maybe like a normal...
Dex?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's 14.
Alright. That is a hit.
You know, before the cart's out of range, I have oil flasks here in the cart. I would like to light one up and throw it at the building that's shooting the bolts out of.
Try to throw it right in the window?
Just, like, at the building so it starts a fire. Because...
Alright.
Yeah, sure. On the second floor and there's a fire, you're not going to want to stay up there very much longer.
Are you...
Yeah. Is this a light or a heavy crossbow?
At least they'll have to deal with something while we get out of here, right?
No, that's brilliant.
Yeah. Alright, so are you going to try and, like, lob it up into the second floor with the guys, or are you just throwing it at the base of the building?
I'm going to try and throw it up at the second floor if I can, but I'm definitely just trying for that building as my main goal.
Alright, so give me a ranged attack. So if you don't have any ranged weapons, that will be a 20 plus your dex plus your proficiency.
I think we should be called the Fire Bandits.
Makes sense.
Is there any bonus added to damage for a crossbow?
I believe the rules are dex. I disagree with that. But...
yeah.
So 12.
I got 7. My dex is plus.
Alright.
That'd be 12.
Sorry, what'd you say, Tina?
12?
Okay. You blow up near the window. So you don't quite get it inside, but it's enough to make the guy duck back before he can take a shot. Your bolt pegs the guy, you hear a grunt, Jordan, and he goes back inside the window. Whether or not he's dead, you don't know, but he definitely isn't sitting there with a crossbow anymore. Okay, so you guys start moving the cart along. Behind you, on the street, you can now see a group of guards. There's about 15 of them. They're running after the cart. I mean, they're like a ways down the street still. They're probably still a few hundred feet away or a couple hundred feet away. But they're yelling, "Halt! Stop! Stop!"
As I'm riding, I'm going to stand up, pull down half my pants, smack my ass at them.
Oh boy. Okay.
Alright, Ashmanis, are you gonna catch up with the cart, or are you still hanging back?
Yeah, we're gonna yell, I'm gonna yell at Ashmanis to go, like, come on, let's go, we're out of here!
Which way are they heading, north, south, east, or west? I know the city. Actually, anyway, I'll just note that, Alec. I'll note which way they're heading, and assume they're going to the nearest gate in that direction.
Okay.
Not 24.
So I'll lean back.
Yeah, that's what I figured. That forest.
I'm assuming you're traveling away from the town center.
Away from the forest. So, I don't ever want to go back to that place.
Okay. Alright, yeah. So you guys are... So that's the direction that you're heading is essentially back the way you entered the city from. Assuming that you're looking to get to an entrance.
Yeah.
Alright, so you head that way, answering as you hang back a little bit. The guards are running down the street. You'll notice, Antimaeus, that a couple black figures pop in the windows again with crossbows when they hear the commotion. They see the guards running by, and they just duck back into the building. They don't take shots. So you guys are riding towards the gate. Occasionally, you see some people run across the street. They look like civilians. You hear some yelling and kind of screaming off the distance. Kind of sounds like horrified as opposed to, you know, being butchered or something as you're kind of riding towards the gate. Several guards run out to the middle of the street from the gate. There's still guys standing at the gate demanding again that you stop the cart.
I'm gonna try and push the horse harder.
Alright. Okay. So you're gonna try and charge through?
Yeah.
Okay. I assume the gate is wide open.
It is at this point, yeah.
Okay, yeah, I guess I should check that. Still drunk, guys. Still drunk.
Just break their necks and crumple to the ground.
The gate's open.
All the meat is spilled everywhere.
Everyone just starts crying.
I just wanted to stay at the inn.
Alright, so you guys will start charging the gate. Try and get through it. Andreas, how long are you hanging back for?
Honestly, so this is 6 seconds rounds of burn initiative. So probably, like, 4 rounds.
Okay.
I'm just steady sitting there waiting.
Alright. The time it'll take them to get to the gate, that amount of time will have come and gone, before they reach the gate. So, are you gonna follow them after, or...?
I'm gonna do a perception, if that's okay.
Yep.
To see if I can hear any movement in the houses.
Yeah, of course.
I got a whopping 9.
Alright. Yeah, you can, the commotion in this area is getting a little bit louder. You can definitely hear people moving in some of the buildings near you. Whether that's a threatening movement or not, you're not sure.
Okay, I'll try to use back alleys and, stay in stealth as best I can and follow them.
Okay, can you give me a stealth check real quick there? So you're kind of, sneaking through the alleys, darting along, you know, making a decent pace to get to them while staying in the shadows.
20.
Alright, nice. So as you're about to turn around a corner, you notice a couple of those pig creatures running down the alley with large weapons in hand, and you duck back in the alley, kind of press yourself up against the wall, and they just seem to run right by you. They don't notice you. Are you going to pursue them, or are you just going to continue on your way?
I might, under my breath, and perhaps mostly in my head, say some comments of disgust and, you know, a variety of swear words of how close that was,
okay.
And then we'll continue.
Alright, you continue down the alleyway. You get to a break in the alley where you can see the front gate. You are looking on at the side. You follow the cart at this point, and guards are shouting for the cart to stop, and Pi just does a... And the horse goes starts trying to gallop towards the gate with this cart on it. The guards yell, drop the portcullis! And this is not really based off of you guys. I'm gonna get all three of you guys.
You know,
pull,
I have animal handling. I just, you know, want to yell at the horses just for more inspiration. With go. All
right. Yeah. Sure. Give me an animal handling check.
Almagar, I kind of picture you with this massive smile and just like jumping with glee on this cart.
What'd you get there, Sina?
9.
Alright. Can I get a dexterity check from the three of you, please? Everybody but Jordan.
Whispering sweet nothings into the horse's ear while he's... I believe in you!
Go, Sina.
20.
Sorry, what was that, Sina?
20.
Okay, 20.
Oh, no, I just added the dex bonus, right?
Chief is also in the cart with us.
9.
15.
You're charging the gate. In the meantime, crossbowmen on the gate rampart fire on you as well.
Everyone in the cities is trying to kill me, so I'm not trusting anyone, not even soldiers.
High armor class is 18.
Yeah.
Okay, Almagar, sorry, yours is?
16.
And Maple, yours is?
Also, mine is 17, but I also want to point out I have danger sense, so I get advantage on dex saving rolls and stuff I can see.
Okay. Alright, good call.
Now's the time to point that one out.
Yeah, so you can roll advantage on that dex check in play. It's not technically you can throw good to you anyways. So you can get a crit out of it.
No, my other one was better, so 20.
Alright. So you guys are, like, galloping on the horse. A bolt flies at each one of you. It strikes each one of you. Maple, you take 3 points. Pythagoras, you take 4. Almagar, you take 2. Most of these are just grazing, but you hear a distinct thud, thud, thud as they hit the cart, and you're just, you know, using a little bit of energy to get out of the way of them. And this thing rushes through the portcullis. You can see some guys up the top bring a hammer down on this latch that really holds the portcullis, and he just hammers it down and goes brrrr, and the gate with these spikes at the top or the bottom of it just goes shh as you're rushing through it. you get the horses through, but it does collide with the back of the cart.
No.
So Pi is up.
This is a sturdy cart. Like, maybe it's a bad name.
So Pi, you're up front. You're good. Maple and Almagar, I do need dexterity saving throws from you to see if you like roll out of the way of the pointy damage dealing things that are coming down on you, and you do get advantage again for danger sense.
If I have athletics, does that help?
Not in this case.
Well,
16.
All right. And 12, yeah. That's with your advantage.
Yeah.
Wow.
I rolled a 1, so yay advantage.
Yeah, good call.
Because you're stuck under the...
Alright, well, luckily, portcullises are not wide range, so it doesn't take much to get out of the way of it. It's just, you know, ones would not be great for you. Yeah, so you both kind of roll out of the way. This thing collides the back of the cart, and the horses just go, as the rear axle is just breaks in on itself, and the wheels just bow out, and the back of this thing just collapses to the ground. The gate doesn't close all the way, it's just punctured kind of the wood and is stuck open, but the cart has come to a complete stop. So, with that, we are going to go into initiative, so I'll get everybody to roll your initiative numbers, please.
God damn.
13.
Alright, 13 for Mabel.
8.
6.
6? Okay.
I'm not last.
8. And Antimaeus. There you go. 14.
So the result is sit on wait for everyone else to make their attacks. And then...
You just don't have a grasp of the situation. I wonder if they're going to try and kill me. I'm just going to wait and see what happens. Oh shit! Oh shit!
But you haven't been here a full day, right?
Nope.
And there have been multiple groups trying to kill us.
Yeah.
Or at least, you know. Yeah, if you want to get out.
How many guards are there?
There's at least 6 that you can see.
Oh boy.
Not including the 3 on the top of the wall.
Okay.
However,
just help me lift this portcullis up.
Yeah. Okay, so Antimaeus, you're up first. What would you like to do? You're just watching the spectacle.
How many guards did you see?
There's 6 on foot, 3 on the wall.
Wait, so where are we? Did we make it past the gate before?
Yeah, you're through the gate. It's just the rear of the cart that got caught by the portcullis.
So they're both on the other side.
So the 6 are on the other side of the gate,
yes. Yeah, just gotta lift up the rear end of the gate to get the cart out.
It's gonna be hard to lift when they did the emergency close, right?
That's what I'm saying. Just guys, help me with this.
Yeah, is the wagon actually stuck? Or is it like broken enough that it can keep going, but...
The portcullis is stuck in the back of it. The rear axle is broken, so the wheels have broken out off of it now, right?
Right.
But the wagon is still kind of held up on the previous rubble of the wheels and axles, so the portcullis is all the way down. It's probably like a foot, maybe 2 feet off the ground, stuck in the rear of the wagon.
Would we be able to actually ride off with this cart, or
it would drag.
Yeah,
so,
okay, that's what I
think. Drag
off. It'd be like a giant sled.
You could.
It
you definitely could, but yeah, you're just gonna be dragging a big piece of wood behind you, essentially.
Okay. Lift all of our supplies, but...
Yeah, and like, so you had a bunch of shit in the back, so it's all like slid to the back, and it's pressed up against the portcullis. like it's leaning against it, right? So if you drive away, it's gonna pull out because the cart is like shaped like this now.
Well, once we go, all the pups might slide up.
Anyway, slash mass. What would you like to do?
Is there a stairwell up to the wall?
There is. Yes.
And from my vantage point, the six cards are going towards the porticlet still.
They are. So.
And then the two on the wall are looking over, probably going to shoot people.
Yeah, yeah, they have crossbows. They're already in the process of reloading them.
How high is this wall?
Pretty high. I mean, it's not crazy, but it's at least 20 feet. So it's, you know, it's not the highest wall I've ever seen, but definitely tall. Oh, shit, sorry. So what, give me an intelligence check, please, there, Ashmaeus.
That is 17.
Alright, one thing you remember is while there's a door on this side of the wall, there is not one on the opposing side of the wall, so it doesn't appear they can walk through any immediate doors. There's probably one on the wall somewhere, because they always exist, but yeah, not near the portcullis. So odds are they're either going to have to jump off the wall or open up the portcullis to get through.
Okay, I'm going to make a run for the stairs as best I can, still trying to be hidden if it's dark enough, hopefully.
Yeah, it is still night, so please give me another stealth check for that, though.
Sure. 16.
You book it towards the stairs, you get to them. Are you going up them?
Yeah, I'm planning going up them.
Alright, so you're stealthy enough that you're able to head up them and no one sees you. But one of the guards on the base catches you while you're about 3/4 of the way up the stairs, and does point you out. But that's the only person that sees you at this point. Anything else you'd like to do?
So I'm at the top of the stairs.
Yeah. Okay.
Does anyone else seem to react to his comment?
One of the other guards who he's closest to just kind of patted him and pointed. He's looking up at you, but the other four and the three on the wall are still just getting ready to fire. They don't seem to see you either.
Okay. I'll just prepare my grappling then.
Okay. Alright, Maple, you're up. What would you like to do?
Throw Chief in my sled out of the back of this cart. And okay. Get them set up.
Okay. Alright, so you're pulling the sled out and you're hooking it up to the dog.
Yeah.
The guards are calling out to the guy on the wall who's got the crank, and he starts going to raise the portcullis, and it's slowly going. The guards are just waiting on the other side, trying to get as low as possible, which is very low because they're wearing armor, and they look like they're going to rush on through. They have the opportunity. The three on the wall are going to take some additional pot shots at you guys.
Can their fire reach us if right against the...
Like they're just looking right over the wall if they need to, right? They can go essentially as low as possible. Maple, they apparently do not like that you are trying to get this sled set up. One bolt does strike you, unfortunately, Maple. For 2 points of damage, another one misses, lands in the mud outside, and then one fires at you too high, but just hits the cart, does not strike you. The two guards that notice you there, Antimas, they're running up the stairs after you. The stairs are only one person wide, so they can't both reach you, but they're kind of one behind the other, and they do reach a point where they're prepared to strike. Okay, Almagar, what would you like to do?
I probably want to free these horses from the cart.
Okay.
I don't remember everything. It was.
Throw them on the sled.
There's a reason why I'm setting this up.
What I was thinking is finding the bag with the gold in it and put it over my back or the chest. That'll act as a...
Yeah, do some of that. I can't carry everything on the sled, but I can carry some of our stuff. So, yeah, take what you can and go!
Yeah, Yeah, so what do you want to do? Grab something?
Yeah, the chest with the gold, and we left the gold in there, I think, right?
Yep.
I want to be able to, like, lift over, kind of, like, the hang, like, it'll be hanging from my hands, so it'll be covering most of my, like, my back, right? And I'll start running.
Alright.
I'm sure my arms and legs will be exposed, but...
Let's, can you give me a strength check, please, and just see how effortlessly you carry this thing? It's pretty heavy. There's a lot of coin in there. I mean, you'll be able to carry it, no problem, but we'll see how quickly you can move.
12. I figured the chest would be pretty good at blocking bolts. Who needs a shield if you just put a chest on your back?
The one thing with the chest, too, so you'll be able to carry it, no problem, and you'll be able to move fairly quickly with it. But the one thing with the chest is that it is in a compartment within the cart that you guys placed it in. So, the question is, the Almagar ever seen this compartment?
I'm sure I would have made note of where that kind of stuff.
Yeah, I would imagine you probably knew it as well.
That's why I mean I didn't think about the feed or anything that's moving. I was like, crap the gold, I've got trail rations.
Yeah. Right, no, that's fine. You you swing open the hidden compartment, you pull out the chest, you carry it, and are you running with it, or what would you like to do when you got it over your shoulder at this point?
Yeah, and I'm just gonna basically run straight down the path, try to, unless there's somewhere I can kind of just hide behind for now, like a hedge or a little wall or fence or something.
Yeah, there's a couple larger rocks that are kind of in front of the wall that you can probably duck behind if you wanted to. Like, probably like 25 feet away from the wall.
Right.
Eight foot so rocks.
Maybe I'll do that for now, and once I get that there, then I can, provide some cover, I guess. All right.
Okay, so you're gonna, you put it in the compartment, you grab the chest, you throw it on your back, you start running towards one of the rocks, you're not gonna be able to get behind it, this action.
Okay.
But yeah, you start moving over there. Okay, cool. Pythagoras, what would you like to do?
Can you imagine someone watching this go down?
Just full flank.
Chance, I can just picture that. Kind of fast motion video over the road.
Yeah.
Is the cart free of the portcullis?
The cart is definitely free of the portcullis now that it's being raised. Yeah, 100%.
Lush, Andale, Vamoose, go. All those things.
Okay, so the horses start dragging the cart behind. You can just hear this.
And as I'm riding off,
at this point, I'd like to remind everyone that they are draft horses, and there are just two of them.
Whatever.
That's okay.
As I'm riding off, so I told you about my backstory with the pirate that's chasing me or whatever.
Yep.
As I'm riding off, I'm going to say, Rolling Calvin strikes again!
Love it. That's great. That's awesome. Okay, so you're riding with these horses, and they're bumping along and just pulling the car behind. You hear, like, this as the couple barrels, like, roll out of the back and roll onto the dirt, but it's a mess. What would you like to do?
I'm gonna look at the two guards approaching. They have swords drawn, right?
Oh yeah.
And I'm gonna have my hands up, and I'm gonna say, the bounty is mine. That's all I want. You can have them. And I'm gonna try deception.
Okay.
I did fairly well. 18.
One of them, the guy that's in front, kind of responds with, "We don't care if you're looking for no bounty. These people are likely criminals. They default to the guards.
If you help me, I'll give you part of the bounty. We can both profit from this.
How about you manage to be useful and help us catch them, and we can talk?
Done. And
all
I
right.
run to the corner, and I clip on the comb. The grappling hook onto the corner of the wall, and then I, like, do a sweet, epic move. Flying down. What do you want me to roll?
If you have athletics or acrobatics. Acrobatics, preferably.
I've got acrobatics.
Alright, perfect.
I got a whopping 11.
Perfect.
But I do it with great intent.
So, yeah, you throw the grappling hook on the edge, you swing over and dive down, and you're thinking to yourself, oh man, I'm gonna like snap out when I jump out, and I'm gonna like flip around and start grappling on the wall. Instead, it's just kind of like this jump, and you kind of like hit the wall, and then you just start shuffling down. it works.
But I land all epic, right? Like all
Oh, yeah. Plant your boots and just like.
Can I attempt to like whip the grappling hook off? I don't know how you're supposed to do
it. Yeah, just give me a dex.
Nat 20.
Oh, yeah. Oh. You just like.
Can I accidentally clip one of the guys with it?
Yeah,
he's trying to get pretty close. Oh,
hey. Like one of the archers.
Yeah, just like clip one of their bows by accident or something.
Yeah, sure. You like yank on this thing, give it enough upwards force, and go, and it just like clips the guy's crossbow, and it rattles out of his hand on the ground. So he has to like bend over to pick it up, and you pull the grappling down.
I wink at him.
Okay. All right. Okay, so you're at the base of the wall. Maple, what would you like to do? Your dog sled is ready.
Well, I head out, follow the cart, and depending on what falls out, I may try and see if I can put it on the sled and go.
Alright, well, everything is falling out, so is there something you have in the cart that you would like to keep?
The chest should be, they're chained in.
Oh, okay.
And then padlocked because I didn't want anyone to steal
the bigger cart. Chest, right?
Yeah, okay. But the barrels of water.
Well, I'm not going to worry too much about the barrels that I can tell are water, but if there is anything like the food or crates, not like the animal feed or anything, but if I can tell that's like actually our provisions, I want to try for that specifically.
Yeah, sure. So can you remind me what was in the chests there, guys?
The chain chests are going to be like copper and silver. Scott would have grabbed the gold. And then...
Also then like some of the group loots or some of the regular...
Yeah, some rings and
okay.
Short swords and tanning supplies and that kind of stuff. Stuff that can't easily be put in bags. Okay. Everything else that's in crates and stuff would be food supplies and provisions for horses.
Okay, yeah. So, yeah, one of the crates there, Maple, is the one that essentially has your iron rations in it that you've, stored for the next while. So, yes, that would
you definitely that see one. That one. Yeah.
All right. So you grab that one, throw on the sled, and start mushing.
Yeah.
All right. So, and your mastiff is just... trying to get away as fast as possible.
I'll like kind of help steer and like help him with that, so it's not putting all the weight on him, because I am proficient with the animal handling and the maneuvering of this, so yeah.
Okay. So the guys on the wall, one of them cannot take a shot because it's not by grappling hook. So clearly the guy who dropped the crossbow must have like started grabbing at the feet of the other guy that was also shooting, and he grabs him, and the guy shoots like really off in some strange direction, and it lands like way over in the distance, and then one of them still gets a decent shot off and just barely misses you there, pie, but does not hit you. And yeah, all right. So the porkless tink, and it's up high enough now for the guards to run through. So four guards are running through underneath the porkless, trying to chase you guys. Yeah. All right, Almagar, what would you like to do?
So they haven't run out very far yet.
You got guards in your tail. They're probably within about 10 feet of you.
So how far have they gone? Because I was thinking as they go by, I was going to kind of join them, but I think you said it was like 25 feet?
Yeah. Yeah, you can get to the cart. If you want to book into the cart, you could be you can get to it and, like, hang on for dear life or something. Like, or sit beside Pi on the rider's saddle area there, too. Whatever you'd like to do.
No, JoJo's sitting there, sorry.
Shit. I need to get this chest back. Where JoJo's sitting. Because I'm going to have to... I'll go try to rejoin the cart. And I'm still trying to use like the chest and the cart, whatever has cover as we go along. And obviously, I'll be ready to... I must be able to put the chest somewhere. I know the cart's in rough shape.
Yeah, theoretically, the secret compartment is, it won't let anything slide out of it, so yeah, you can toss the chest back in there.
Oh, okay, cause, yeah, maybe I'll do that as I go and try to use it as cover as a boot, just so...
Alright, oh, yeah, so you run to the cart, throw the chest back in the compartment, you're kind of hanging onto the cart as it's driving away, then. Okay, alright.
Try to help it along, like,
we're gonna push.
Yeah, where's he going?
Alright. Okay, Pi, are you just continuing on with the ride?
Oh, yeah. All laughing. I'm actually having a lot of fun.
Woo!
Mad laughter!
Probably a little
bit. Scrap Lake City.
Multiplying by your head.
Reminds me of home.
Lack of sleep. Yeah, everything.
That's fantastic, too.
I'm just gonna... I'm gonna use the word disengage because that's what the rogue skill says. And then I'm gonna run deeper into the forest and just run parallel to the cart. I wanna keep an eye on the barrels that are coming out to see if I can notice the very special barrel.
Mm-hmm.
We'll call it the peg barrel.
Peg of beer. Peg of wine.
Yeah, you definitely notice it rolling along.
Ooh. I will deviate from my path. How heavy was it?
Not that. It was a small little cap.
Oh, I will deviate and pick that sucker up.
Yep. All right. Yeah. So you grab it. You're just gonna keep on sprinting.
Yeah. I kind of want to sprint with the guard. Almost. Like just behind them.
Okay.
And then if anyone looks, I'm gonna say get them.
A
couple of the guards looked at you funny, but then that guy you said that you were a mercenary to kind of goes, yeah, he's helping. Don't worry about it. And they stop paying attention to you. And they all keep on running. The cart and you guys are at this point are ways off. I mean, you're not much faster than people, but you're faster than people enough with the horses pulling a big board of wood that, you know, you're making a little bit distance, and the guy that you had convinced you were a mercenary there, Antimaeus, yells back at them and goes, come back, you fools, we need all the guards in the city, don't go chasing them. Likely, those people are not who we're looking for, and he kind of looks at you and says, you look like the one closest, but you claim you're a mercenary. Why don't, since they're getting away from you as well, why don't you come back with us and maybe you can answer a few questions?
I'll toss them the wine as I'm running.
Yeah.
And be like, have a drink on me, but my job's not done. And I'll keep running.
Oh! Alright.
Oh, that's brilliant.
It's gonna be, I'm gonna, like, if anyone's looking back, I'm gonna have one of those, like, Pirates of the Caribbean guy, Captain Jack Sparrow looks. Know with that really stupid run.
Okay. Alright, you guys can look back and see Antimaeus going all T2, just
yelling, come back, you fools, come back.
Alright. They don't seem to pursue you past that point. The guards have turned around and gone back to the city. However, you'll notice that they drop the portcullis again once they're back inside. Potentially not willing to make the same mistake they just made.
they totally have the wine in hand, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yes!
You just put it down on some table near the gate. All right, so you catch up with.
You couldn't like stick around and wait for someone. Stay back in the city just
guys. I know we need to get away. But we should totally go watch what happens.
All the stuff we could have done with that.
I'm totally gonna yell like they're not chasing us anymore.
Okay, are you guys gonna make your way into the forest?
I think to the edge.
Well, we could see they're not pursuing, right? Obviously, we're watching.
Yeah,
right?
That's why I said that. You guys can tell.
Is that the?
But we'll slow down. We'll need to find, you know, as far as we know, they might come back or more might be coming. So we'll at least try to.
Why don't we set up camp here, and I'll go back and make sure no one's following us.
Okay, yeah, and I'll try to fix the wagon if I can, fix the wheels at least.
This wagon.
We do have spare wheels.
I can help.
Actually, yeah, let's get like a group thing going here. Come on, team, let's fix that wagon.
Yeah, you said you had spare wheels.
Yeah, because I think we got it reinforced, and then we got spare wheels that are, like, reinforced wheels or whatever, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we had.
Because we knew we were going to kill this thing.
Yeah. We knew we were going to be hard on it.
All right, so are you guys entering the forest to make camp, or are you making it on the edge of the forest?
Yeah, no, edge of the forest. I don't think we should enter.
Is this the forest that we, like, with the creepy witch and all that?
Yeah, this is the one. No, we're not going in there. No. Well, so... You enter the forest with the creepy witch and shit. You got to Umbermill, which was the small town, and that kind of got a little bit of clearing, but it's sort of a lumber town, so it's pretty much surrounded by forest, and you continued on past there, and then it re-entered the forest. And this would be the area after Umbermill, between Umbermill and the city. So nothing weird happened in this one.
Yeah,
maybe safe.
Yeah,
just
a little bit in, though, not too deep.
Yeah, just enough to give us cover.
Yeah.
Okay, so just enough to get a little bit of cover, and then,
I can find us food and stuff, then, too, tonight.
Okay.
So we don't have
to... We don't have to have a fire, but any pieces that would need, like, you know, birds or, you know, axle or something, Mike would go and chop, you know, with some nearby trees. That should be easy enough to...
Okay. Alright, so are you guys staying right on the road, or are you ducking into the brush and stuff a little bit?
Into the brush.
Okay.
Anywhere we can find like a rock outcropping or a hill or a dip or somewhere we can just kind of lay low.
Yeah, so you can get in there.
Between
if
you and me being barbarians, we could actually help with that setting up the camp properly.
Sure, okay.
Because we have the natural geography.
Yeah, there. about like 30 or 40 feet into the forest, you find kind of a little area that you could probably squeeze the broken ass cart into so it can be off the road as well.
Perfect.
And yeah.
And then, being a barbarian, I'm not much for covering tracks, but I'll just go and kind of, if I see anything else, kind of like, you know.
Take them around.
Walk around back. And...
If I step in the backwards, they should disappear.
We can't see each other out, right?
Alright, so you said you're running back after this?
Yeah, I'm gonna head back in the cover near the forest edge, and then I'm gonna go see if there's anyone coming back.
Alright.
Like if they're coming with horses or something.
If no one's coming and it's all safe, you should grab one of those water barrels we left behind too. Then.
Yeah.
Do you want me to give you Chief in the sled?
Just
in case.
No, that's okay.
You're good?
He might bark.
Give me a perception, please. And the three of you guys are, since you're all working together, I'm assuming to try and repair this cart a little bit. Yeah. Can each of you give me an intelligence check, please? And if you think you have an applicable skill that might help as well, just let me know. 19. Okay. Yeah, you see several figures running from the wall, not from the gate, like not directly from the gate down the path, but from the side of the wall. They're running to a parallel piece of the forest to where you guys would be. So not to the path, but they're entering the forest for sure.
And are these guys rather tall? Or a few of them nimble?
There's a few of them that are quite tall, and then there's several leading them that are nimble. They're walking.
Yeah.
And faster, kind of at a jog. But the big guys like just walking along, and then there's a few more guys running beside them.
Do I happen to hear any choking or merrymaking?
No, you hear the occasional shout and stuff from the city still, but odds are at this point they haven't cracked your special wine yet.
Darn. Okay, I'll hustle back.
Okay.
So 13 now?
13, okay.
And 21.
21.
9. Maybe I'll just feed the horses.
I'll help fix the wagon. Horses.
Maple's like, just go feed the horses. For sakes. Get out of the way. Slowing us down.
Yeah, so you guys should be able to do some makeshift repairs to it. They won't last for a long journey, but it at least gets wheels on the thing again. It'll probably take you several hours. Now, you guys are getting a little bit tired at this point, too, so you can choose to repair it right now and rest later, or whatever you guys like to do, but, yeah.
I'm gonna repair
it'll take
it,
yeah.
We don't want to be making too much noise while we're doing this, too. 2 o'clock in the morning, you're hammering stuff right next to a tablet. I'm just going to let Maple and Pythagoras, you know, if you want to take turns, you know, fine. I'll have a nap now and you guys can wake me up when you're ready to
So how about this? Elgamar, you're in charge of feeding the horses and feeding the dogs right now, making sure that they're fed. They can go and guard the surrounding area while Pythagoras and myself will do the repairs on the cart right now while Antimaeus is out scouting ahead and seeing if we're being chased. And once you're done feeding the horses and everything, then you can get some food together for us.
and there we go.
Yeah, and then we'll all rest later and we'll figure out if the dogs will be doing guard duty overnight or whatnot, but at least
we'll be ready
to go if we have to bust out of here again.
I just picture you talking down to him, just being like, sweetie, no, go make your dinner.
He's my cousin.
Little special.
Okay, his side of the family married into ours, you know.
Yeah. With the crate of food, the fruit and whatnot, is there anything like apples that are spoiled or like broken because of the?
There's like a few that are beaten up, bruised. Luckily, the thing was actually packed pretty well, so they didn't move around a ton.
The ones that are beaten up and bruised, I'll go and give the horses as a treat, and then give them the regular hay. And, you know, like, said, good job, they kind of did just save our asses there. So I'll tend to them a bit, and then, you know, I'll get some cheese and stuff ready for the others.
All because else. You rolled a 9.
Well, I think, too, probably, I'm still bleeding the shoulder. And I hurt, too,
but I'm just like, fix everything first, and then we'll deal with all of that after.
You, like, grab an apple and shine it on your shirt, just, like, cover it in blood.
we're barbarian
whining as he's trying to whittle wood.
So I guess also while we're fixing this and hanging out right now, future plans, where are we going from here? I don't know the surrounding area and be like, let's go on to the next village, but I could dictate it's probably that way. And I'm not going back through this forest if I can help it. Didn't like this one. Not good vibes here. But,
we need to find a way around.
We can always go around the city and, like, not actually go in, but from here on, where are we going? What are we doing? Are we... I don't know. We still have these pigmen after us. City guard, for some reason, didn't like us. Like, we weren't even in town a day, guys. Like, something's going on. Like,
Makes me want to head east to that city and help them.
Where is that?
Attack this
and
city.
Do we actually want to go in there? Do we want to look for work? Or are we going to try and pick something up in the forest? Like, try to, I don't know, our hand at picking up a few deer or bear or something?
We can open a mushroom market. Some mushrooms.
I could find those for you. But mushrooms are, you gotta be careful where you're getting them.
But well, you have highly poisonous here in Faerun. The kinds you hide behind the shelf.
But yeah, seriously, like what's our plan of action? Like, we got some gold and like some money from this.
We just need to find a
villager
town that isn't trying to kill us.
Well, that too.
We're actually pretty wealthy now.
Well, that's just it. That's what I mean. Like, we got money now, so it's just a matter of what.
Spend it before we lose it.
Do we want to invest it in something? I would like to put my hand in for my share. I would like to get my weapons done up in silver, especially those daggers. So that's kind of my future plan. So yeah, if we could find a city at some point, but not right now on my list of priorities.
The only other place we really know of is the city in the east, right?
For right now, my two senses, I don't think we should split up. I think we should all stick together until we know at least who's looking for us and which one of us in particular. Because that note didn't really tell us a whole lot.
Because we came across a few different people in that forest alone, or plus the people, or yeah, there's all kinds of.
But if we do head to another city, like what are we looking for? Are we gonna look for work? And if so, like what line of work? Like Etmea said, we have, you know, wealth now, so it's just a matter of, is that what we want to pursue more of, or do we want to try investing some of our bits? Maybe right now would be a good time to get some rest and then divvy everything up right now and figure out what our portions are.
Yeah, because even, I think Alex is saying something about a couple hundred gold just for the silver to do the thing, right? So, if we divvy it all up, we'll all be able to upgrade and do something like that, similar things.
And I mean, too, right now, if we divvy it up, at least then, I don't know, it might help some individual goals, perhaps? I don't know what your guys' plans are, but...
We can work towards that while I'm sure this is the last we've seen these pig guys or whatever, and we'll still have to...
Well, yeah, like, obviously they're gonna still be at us, so that's why I said I don't think it's a good idea for us to split up. That's why I believe we should all still travel together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then see where... Yeah, we need to find our purpose, or what we're actually... So far, we've just been in the sense of trying to get away from that.
I just want to go until we find a city. I'm really on edge about the note and all that stuff, so...
But is the city a good option for us? Maybe staying out...
I've been city hopping since I was 16, so that's all I know, really. That's all I want to do. But my long-term goal is to make a name for myself, right? I want people to know I'm a hero, blah, 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 you know. So getting work would be a good start for that.
Well, now, I mean, maybe not. I mean, you got some money, maybe you hire yourself a bar.
That's pretty tempting.
Hey, bar, sing songs of me all the time.
Why not? I got drums. I can't sing, but I can play a war beat.
Bring your brain supplies. Bring that away. Yeah.
Were you able to bring back water?
I'm not back yet, and I don't know if I grabbed any water.
Oh,
and it's probably too heavy for me anyway.
You can roll it. I don't know, I'm a barbarian.
Most of those pieces fell off in the gate, so it depends on how close you get to the gate.
Let me know when I get back, and I'll tell them my story.
Alright, you can move back now.
The water jugs exploded, and they were unsalvageable,
and people are coming to murder you from the forest side, so get your crap together, and I'm gonna go hide.
Well, good thing they fixed the cart.
The cart will take a few hours, so Antimaeus has only gone about, like, 15 minutes or so. So still got a lot of work to do.
Yeah, we'll just keep working on the cart.
This is a good time, Scott, to tell him that you're proficient in land vehicles.
Yeah, this might be the time to bring that up.
The horses are eating apples in their back.
We want to be well, I'm the one with the animal handling and should be doing that.
I'm going to try to do what I was doing before and actually, like, you know, with my, I've got the hand axes and the great axe and actually cut it at decent. Actually, I've got the regular axe too. Yeah. Anyway, yeah, we're, again, trying to fashion the parts we need.
So you guys are doing repairs, or are you doing anything else?
Shit, we still need to sleep. But that's not going to happen. So yeah, I'm just going to try to do these repairs as quick as possible.
We can always sleep once we can get going on the cart.
Yeah.
Okay, so otherwise you guys are just going to hang out and do the repairs.
Yeah.
And then maybe, and while I'm doing this, I'm also just, you know, looking over my shoulder and, you know, repairing.
You don't need to guard. We got the dogs for that.
I love like, my crossbow.
Okay. You said you're hiding as well, right? Yeah, okay.
It's going to be kind of like, you know, I'm training it on Scotticus. Or not Scotticus. I'm just kind of like going from person to person to be like, ooh, so easy, so easy.
Every time he points the crossbolt at me, even though I'm not looking, I'm just like, it's like someone's looking at me. I just got this sense that something's not right. We need to hurry up with these repairs and get out of here, guys.
Just like making your little, like, homemade, like, little crosshair.
Bang! Die. Bang!
Bang! About an hour passes when the dogs start freaking out, and from the trees bursts two more of these pig-faced creature dudes. Alright, I need initiative again, guys.
Oh, and there go the dogs!
Eighteen.
14.
20. Amagar. So, two of these pig-faced guys burst out of the trees. You're hacking away, fashioning some wood for like
they. And how far away are they? Like, I mean, like, if I just stand up and swing, they're there. Or
oh yeah, they're like right there. Yeah, it's a pretty dense forest. You guys are in like little clearing, but these guys are, yeah, running right out of the trees.
Okay. In that case, I'll assume I've got my great axe anyway.
Yep.
And I'll just basically just set up and just do one big
okay.
Swing and.
Alright, give me an attack roll.
Swing and a miss. 18.
Okay. That's definitely a hit.
6 damage.
Nice. Alright. So you swing, you slash at one of these things, it gives you this snarl and bear's teeth at you, and it's got this big two-handed sword thing that looks like it wants to use next. Alright, Mabel, what would you like to do?
I'll pull out my spear and go for the other closest one.
Okay, alright, so you go for the other one.
15 hit?
Yes, it does.
Oh, awesome. Okay. Didn't think it would. 10 damage.
Alright, so you hit the guy for 10 damage, leaving a large open wound. Okay, he does a similar kind of snort gurgle at you. And yeah, the next mask will
do. Can I do a perception to see if I see the other two masked men? I expect them, but I don't see them, so that's an 11.
Alright, you make out one of them.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and he's he's sort of directly across from where you're hiding right now, so across.
Does he have a crossbow or anything?
Yeah, he sure does.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm gonna attempt to shoot him in the face.
Yeah.
Good place.
To face.
specifically the face. I don't have do I have advantage on him by chance?
Yeah, that's fine. He has no idea you're there.
Oh,
so.
Yes, that didn't count.
He will suit up.
So that is a whopping 11.
Yeah, unfortunately it fires and smokes the tree behind him. It does kind of give you a startled look, however.
Can I do disengage and try to move to a different tree?
Yeah. Alright, Pythagoras, what would you like to do?
Should I have rolled initiative for JoJo?
I'm treating him on your turn. So if there's any actions he like not to take, he has to go on your turn.
Okay, so I can go and he can go?
Yeah, pretty much. Okay.
Alright, so I'm gonna say JoJo, pincer. And he's gonna go behind the one that's Maple. And then I'm gonna go behind the one that is attacking Almagar.
So alright.
We're flanking.
Awesome. Okay. So you can give me your attack roll there.
15.
Okay, definitely a hit.
Oh, does that give me advantage?
If they're flanking?
God, it's been so long. I think so, yeah. Yeah, I'm just gonna say yes for now. Yes, get advantage. Okay.
Yeah, like 27.
Oh yeah.
And JoJo. 22 for JoJo.
Okay, that
matters.
Now 10 damage from me.
20 from the dog.
7 from JoJo.
Wow. Okay.
And the pigman must succeed on a DC 11 strength or knock prone.
Alright, he does succeed on that. So you kill the one creature that you were attacking. The dog does not kill his, but he's close.
Yep.
So it's biting up the thing. It's getting a little chaotic. Yeah. So the one goes down. The other has the choice of the dog. Apparently does not like the dog ripping apart his legs. Alright, swings at JoJo. Barely misses. The dog is just too short. Just too high. And JoJo is alright. Okay. From the trees, however. Sorry, Maple, apparently you're just not a threat.
Oh yeah, it's just a woman.
She's got female armor on. Just can't get a
pick. What armor?
Yeah. Two fire at you, Pi. One fires and misses, the other, the crossbow, actually, something goes wrong with it, and the mechanism in it blows up, and the crossbow just, like, or the bolt just, like, slumps out of it. So the guy just drops it, and he now has to draw a weapon instead. The two that are firing at you, Almagar.
Actually, it's each other.
One misses, and plants in the tree beside you. One, however, does hit you for 4 points of damage. Almagar, what would you like to do? There's one pigman, heavily wounded, still standing, and then there's four of these kind of shadowy figures that have stepped out.
Are they fairly close together, the masked figures, or are they spread out?
Yeah, they're spread out.
Okay, I guess whichever one is closest to me.
Okay.
If they're using crossbows, they're not point blank range, are they? Are they actually right? There's some distance between us.
There's a little bit, yeah. It's like, it's so the coach, and they're kind of on the edge of it in four areas you guys aren't fighting the pigmen in, so like, max 10 feet, 10, 15 feet.
Oh, okay, so I can easily, okay.
Oh, yeah, you can get them.
Yeah. I'll just take a run and start at, I guess, the others closest to me there.
Sure, okay, alright.
I'm gonna rage. I'm already tired, why not rage?
Yeah, exactly.
I just wanted to go to bed! In a tavern! In a city that's not trying to kill me!
That's not so much to ask! Oh.
16. Or these guys.
16, yeah, that's definitely it.
8 damage.
Alright.
Almost just as much as the dog right now.
You
rawr!
Get angry and you swing that axe and you just beat the guy. Maple, what's
up? I'll continue stabbing at the guy, I guess, that Jojo knocked over.
Okay.
The big guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, one that's right there at my feet. 12 hit?
No.
Oh, wait, not. Wait, I get advantage because he's flanked.
Right.
Just no.
24 hit!
Yes.
10 damage.
Alright. Kill it.
Just right through the throat.
Nice. Alright. Spear right through the throat.
And then I will turn and move to the closest masked man.
Okay. Alright.
And use my bonus action then to go into a rage.
Okay. You go into a rage. Okay.
Back to kill all these pig fuckers.
That's my ass place to do.
So both the orcs are down, correct?
Yes.
And then four masked men came out of the woods, one crossbow exploded.
One crossbow exploded, so he's got a sword drawn, and then the other one was cleaved down by Almagar.
Oh,
the point three.
That's it.
And I moved in front of one.
I will drop my crossbow, making a mental note of where it is.
Okay.
And I'll pull my dagger and sword and try to flank around to engage.
Give me a stealth. For
sure. 16.
Alright. So he doesn't notice you, so you can attack and give me advantage.
So on the short sword, that's a 26
hit. Yep.
And then can I dagger his face as well?
Oh yeah.
That's less good.
You just slice the end of his nose off instead.
Yeah. Just take both of them. 16.
You should go ahead.
I will whisper soft nothings in his ear as he falls to the ground.
Hi, what did you
do? There's two left?
Guy, one with a sword, one with a crossbow. Or, sorry, did you kill the guy with a sword, or did you get a crossbow?
Either or.
Okay.
I would say whatever's closest to me. But
yeah. Okay. So you should die crossbow.
Brilliant.
Alright.
Okay, so I guess Jojo and I will pincer the guy with the sword then.
Okay.
I want to try to do, like, non-lethal damage. I just want to knock him out, basically.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. Theoretically, as long as you don't do massive damage, you don't have to shoot the other.
Two natural 20s.
Oops.
I just tried not good.
20 for me and 7 for Jojo.
Alright, so you.
Oh, wait.
Get...
Sorry. Advantage. 18 for Jojo. 6 damage from me and 6 damage from Jojo.
You knocked the guy out. One guy left. Oh, he's gonna sprint into the woods.
I'm chasing! I'm chasing!
Runs.
I'm chasing. And yeah, that's just it. I'm gonna chase and throw my spear. I'm raging.
Alright, the guy's running. Almagar, what would you like to do?
How can I run and reach him, or would it be better off throwing some axes at him?
He's running in the woods, right? So axes are gonna be really hard line of sight. So if you're gonna want to see the guy, you're pulling out and chase him.
Oh, okay. It's probably not open enough people to a javelin at me.
And you can attempt to, but again, he's just turned tail and he's booked in trees, right? So you can kind of guess where he's at and try and throw a javelin through him, but...
Right. No, I'll just chase after him then.
Okay. Alright, so you sprint into the woods there. Can you actually give me an athletics roll, please?
So that would be 18.
Alright. Yeah, you catch up to the guy. You sprint right after him, and you're just like...
So this, yeah, three acts up in the air, and it's
like... Yeah, give me an attack roll.
15.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
You're now chasing two people. Yeah, no, it's just like... Crunch, skull caves in, and just like cuts right down the spine. The guy's back opens up, it's pretty gross, but he just collapses the...
Love it.
Falls right into the one that he was running at in front of him.
soon as that's done, I'm basically going to stop and just try to observe my surroundings, right? Trying to, like, look and see if I see or hear anything else move.
You see the 30 crossbows pointed at him. all right. Yeah, you kind of pause. Maple, you catch right up with them, like, right after you see the handiwork there. And yeah, after a moment or two, you guys semi-confident that you're no longer in immediate danger, so you guys are out of initiative at this point.
Well, I still have a minute left in my rage mode, so I'm just gonna kind of stand there, like, almost foaming at the mouth, and then I'll sprint back, I guess, to the group. I'm not even thinking of looting the bodies. Yeah, I'm gonna run back to the group and just kind of be frantic, I guess.
Alright.
I'll search this guy's body while I'm in rage mode.
You find a sack of a small little purse that probably has coins in it. Probably too angry and out of count, but but otherwise, yeah, it doesn't have anything too remarkable on it.
No notes or anything. I'll go join the party.
Alright, you guys are all back, hanging around at the cart. Some of you more angry than others.
So, I will loot the ones near myself and Pythagoras, I believe. I think he kept one breathing.
Yeah, I want to, I'm gonna loot him, obviously, and I'm also going to strip him down to his boxers and tie him up to the tree.
He wears briefs, sorry.
Or briefs.
Are you going to make any special provisions to keep him alive, or are you just gonna kind of let him out?
Is he bleeding?
Yeah, I mean, with knocking somebody unconscious, you're essentially putting them below zero hit points. They're not dead, but they're still making death saves, essentially, right? So, yeah, I'm assuming you're just not being violent with them, I guess.
Yeah, I'm gonna try to keep them alive.
We keep up an answer.
Yeah, exactly.
That's me, Almagar, sitting there. This guy better fucking talk.
Two barbarians just wah!
Jock, damn it! I punched him in the stomach, and instead just right the guy. Oh my god. I'm so sorry. Alright, Almagar, from the purse you picked up, there's 2 silver and 11 copper in there. Total from yours, Jordan, there is 10 silver and 12 copper.
Was there anything on my guy?
Yeah. 5 silver, cool. 11 copper.
A little amounts like this, I'm not going to bother putting into the group loot, but I mean, obviously anything I find of significance.
There's 2 working crossbows, right?
Yes.
And some bolts?
So 2 working crossbows, there's a total of 12 bolts between the 3 of them. And they also have the leather armor, obviously, and each has a short sword.
I'm going to wander over and take a close look at one of the crossbows, kind of. Sure. Because I don't know, used that much. I would have been trained, like, basic training in my swordry.
And coming out of rage mode.
Pretty primitive, as you remember. You know, they're not fancy devices by any means, and a lot of people that use them as unskilled. But they definitely have their uses. They're good at puncturing armor, and a lot of assassins actually prefer crossbows over bows because they're easier just to fire off and kill somebody as opposed to having to line up, draw and all the rest of it.
Mm-hmm. Back in the day, you're a pirate, you have 2 guns on you, 1 shot each, right? Once they're gone, they're gone.
Yeah, you just toss them away. Yeah.
So I'm just going to wait till that guy comes to. Questioning.
All right. Okay. Would anybody else like to do anything while we're waiting for this guy to wake up?
Yeah, I'd like to go back and continue fixing the cart.
All right.
Yeah, I'll do the same. Yeah. I'll take a few minutes to do a few bandages and stop some of the bleeding.
No, I'm not doing any of that. I'm just going back to the cart.
Okay.
I rub some dirt in it and I'm moving on.
I was just going to say, I need to find a bunch of salt and rub salt in the wound that I can continue.
There's
on.
Salt on the cart!
Alright, so you guys work on some repairs. After just a little bit longer than what you would guess, probably about an hour, the guy slowly kind of opens his eyes and squints at you and just kind of lets out this.
Oh, somebody's awake. How many fingers am I holding up?
How many lights?
He kind of jerks his body a little bit, realizing now that he's tied up and also cold. Kind of naked.
So depending on your answers, may or may not kill you. What do you want from us? Who are you?
I'm no one, and I personally don't want anything from you.
Well, the crossbows and daggers say differently.
Yes. The person who hired me, I'm sure, wants something from you, but I personally want nothing from you.
Cool, smartass. Who hired you?
Yes, say that obviously. I choose not to answer.
Hey,
I plead the fifth.
I'm actually being very gentle here. Usually we have a friend that interrogates people. Antimaeus?
I walk over, pretending to be mute.
Okay. He looks at you and goes, you're dressed up like one of us.
Why do you think that is? Maybe because he's killed a whole bunch of you.
Ah, well, some of the guys I work with aren't that skilled.
And you're saying you are? You're the one that's naked tied to a tree?
Yeah. Not arguing that. I'm also not dead.
Who's your employer? I kick him in the nuts.
He looks at him. Ooh. And he just kind of like, ooh. He's dry heaving a little bit.
I don't know if you noticed the frothing barbarians that are around here either. I could just let them go. Have fun with you. I hear they like to rape.
I mean, my rape stick.
I'm pretty sure that just for that moment, I'll stop working on the cart and just kind of look over. And then just go back working on the cart.
I'll do the same thing, kind of give that look and kind of like...
And he looks to Maple and then looks to Almagar. And says,
I would like to try and look intimidating, even though I'm not very good at that. But you know, just for sake and purposes.
I'm good at intimidating.
Intimidating look from Maple. He kind of glances from Maple to Almagar, and it's like, depending on who's doing the raping, I might not mind.
Well, I call dibs.
All I can picture is Almagar just like... You're fine.
Hello,
yeah?
Well, it looks like Almagar's up first.
I'm gonna kind of almost get up like excited, like, is it my turn?
I hear Maple likes to use acorns.
Alright.
I'll start kicking his legs apart.
Doing what?
I'll start kicking his legs apart.
Kicking his legs apart. Oh, I see. Okay. I was picturing like a part of like destroyed, not he just kinda sits there with a blank stare on his face.
Go to his happy place.
They taught you.
So I'm assuming you're not.
I'm just gonna say, does he at least know why people are trying to kill us?
Yeah, I was just gonna ask that. Yeah. So I'm assuming you don't want to give up information, but is there any information that you can give up or want to give up?
What? So is it just my life on the line for me giving you information? Is that what I'm getting out of this?
Your life, And your ass.
what guarantee do I have that you're not just gonna kill me immediately after I talk? Because I'll tell you what, the people that if you did leave me alive, and the people that I'd be talking about here probably do a hell of a lot worse things to me than any of you can.
Well,
ooh, challenge accepted.
So, like, how do I know that you're even gonna let me live after this?
Antimanus, do you have a forgery kit or something like that?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah. Well, we could forge you a new identity and send you on your way, and they won't be able to find you, hopefully. I mean, that's completely up to you once you're gone.
Wow, that's remarkably kind for someone you've tied up naked to a tree. interesting. Alright, yeah, that's actually kind of interesting to me. Okay, sure. So what did you want to know?
I want to know who hired you, why they're after us.
Okay. Well, I'll be honest with you. I don't fully understand who hired us. I belong to a group of people that were hired, and I have a boss who tells me who I'm looking for and what to do with them. So I don't know why they want you, honestly. All I was told, all any of us were told, is that we need one of you alive and in a position to talk, and the others, doesn't matter, the others can be dead. They didn't specify which one of you, they just said any one of you. So, if I were, you know, a guest man, I would say that they'd probably want some kind of information from me, so you guys must know something that they also want to know. But I'm sorry, who hired us? I have no idea.
What's the group called?
I just get my orders, and I do.
What's the group called that you were hired by?
Black Suns.
Black Suns? Are they a well-known mercenary group or something? Or?
Yeah, we're pretty prominent, you could say, I suppose. Recently, it seems like we've been doing a little less freelance, you know what I mean? We seem to be kind of under the grasp of new ownership, but I don't really know a lot about that.
Is there a specific location that you guys are, have a hideout or something, HQ?
Yeah, in the city that you guys just ran from. We have a location there. Otherwise, we're located in other places too.
Are there other groups that are hired, that have been hired to find us?
Not to my knowledge. I mean, unless you want to count those things, and he looks at the kind of pig-like creatures as another group, but that's left to interpretation.
They're not a part of the Black Sun.
No, God. No. I don't know what the hell those things are. Whoever's been hiring us and setting them on our missions with us, to be honest, they're too clumsy and violent to do good work, but...
Do you know where the orders are coming from? Like a specific city or anything like that?
No, sorry, they're just distributed out to us. I mean, I give you the man who gave me the orders, or gave all of us the orders in that city you just left. Otherwise, I can't really tell you much. I really don't know. I'm not withholding anything. You can trust me on that. I've got nothing else to hide from you, really, at this point. You're either going to kill me or someone else is, so...
Just a random question as I sit up from working on helping on the cart there. Has there been, like, any creepy, older man that's in a dark robe that has come through town at all lately? This guy gives you bad vibes. That's pretty much the only description I can...
So, do you have a name for the... The guy that's in the city that gave you the distributed the notes.
The guy who gave me the order.
Yeah.
Helst Griffin's son.
What was it? Helst?
Helst. K-E-L-S-T. That would be the man you want to find, but I'll give you a warning that he's not the nicest guy in the world, and he's definitely not undefended either. So you better really want to know why. If I were you, honestly, if I were to give you some advice, I'd hightail it out of here. Probably got, you know, a week or so of travel. Just don't go to any major cities. Keep to yourselves. Who knows? Maybe they'll give up on you. Probably a safer bet than going to Kel's directly.
Hmm. Where is the hideout in the city?
If you go to the main square, you'll look to the north. There's a very dingy looking alley with a few kind of drapes over it. You head in there, you go down a set of stairs on the right to what looks like the back of a tavern called the Alley Cat. You knock on the door 3 times. Somebody will open it. They're gonna ask for a password.
And the password?
Password is, you know, creatively enough, Black Sun.
Very creative, yes.
Yeah, luckily most don't really exist.
I just wanna roll an insight to just make sure he's not lying to a thief. 7.
Yeah, you're not sure. He's pretty trustworthy. You don't know.
Is there anything else we should ask this guy?
How long have these pigmen and, like, your employer been hired? Like, when did you guys get hired on with this contract?
I'd say a few 10 days ago. Not long. At least that was when I was brought privy to it, so that was the first job I had. Now, whether or not they were talking before that, there's just no way for me to know.
Anybody else want to ask something?
I'm pretty busy fixing the car. I'm just gonna keep doing that.
Alright, well, I'm a man of my word. Antoneus forge you up a new identity, and I'll send you on your way.
I appreciate that.
And remember, the one that spared your life is Pythagoras.
I'll remember the name, friend. Alright, so you're gonna let him down and stuff then?
Once the documents are made up, I'll get them to him. I'll let him go.
Alright, are you actually going to try and forge some documents there in the mess?
I'll make them look official, but I'm not wasting any of my special paper.
Alright.
I'm giving him, like, a ridiculous name, like Longshanks or something.
Holy shit, okay. Alright. So, the documents are made up.
What did I take off from you? You were just wearing black leather and a sword or something?
Yeah, short sword, black leather.
Yeah, I'll give him those back.
Okay. Alright, so you let him down then?
Yeah.
Back to clothes?
Yeah.
Okay. So he gets down, starts putting on his clothes, takes the sword, thank you kindly, grabs the documents, assuming you're giving it to him.
When he goes to reach him, I'm gonna stab him.
God damn it.
Okay. Alright, just give me an attack roll.
I'm gonna do one of those, like, hug stab.
Okay. Alright, give me an attack roll, you get an advantage on it.
We're gonna kill the
ball. Oh, yeah, you stick the blade into him. Are you looking to kill him?
Yeah.
Okay.
And so I'm gonna sink the blade into him and be like, you're full of crap.
Okay. Alright. As he's dying, he says, I hope they get you, and I hope they do whatever it is they want to do to you. And he kind of gurgles on his own blood and chokes and falls over dead.
I'm never gonna get famous, that man.
I kick the body.
Well, I guess we take back the armor and weapon that we just gave him.
Okay.
He's
doing the best to make the guy think he's gonna get away and live another day with him.
So what are we looking at for repairs now on the wagon?
Not much longer, but another hour.
Okay, cool. Plugging away on that then.
So you guys spend another hour working on the cart, get it working, fixed up. You're pretty confident that it's now drivable again. It's not quite early morning yet, but you can tell that the night is lightening up just a little bit. Can't see the sun on the horizon yet, but yeah.
This would be the perfect time to leave, take some time away from here, and then we can set up camp somewhere before nightfall, away from this city, and somewhere and get some rest for the evening. Just try and stay hidden from this group for now until we can get some rest up. I think would be the best.
Which direction do we want to head? Because we're definitely not heading.
Not going in this forest.
Oh, hells no. I'll go back to the city. Right, I'll walk up to the beach before I head into that forest.
You got the forest to the west, you got the city to the east, or you can take roads north or south.
It just seemed. I was like, God damn it.
Does anyone know what's north or south?
I would say, as far as I know, I don't know myself. We never did find a map, did we?
Nope.
Did you know there's another city further to the east as well? If you were to bypass the one that is directly to the east, that's the one that they're potentially talking of war with.
Hmm. Maybe they'll be nicer in that city.
So tell
them the previous city tried to kill us. We want to get revenge. It's like, oh, what do you know? We just happen to go to attack them.
I doubt it. I think cities are a bad idea.
Do you guys want to try to head north or south?
Yeah, I'm thinking north.
Are we supposed to look for someone in the city?
Really?
Yeah.
It's probably the same guy who's trying to kill us.
No.
Maybe I don't know.
It's
so fucking weird. You're going to look for the friend of the,
yeah.
The hunter.
Yeah.
So, the assassin said that he was called with his job a 10 day or so ago?
Yeah.
How long were we traveling for?
Well, 10 days to the forest, was it? No, not that long.
Yeah, I was going to
take it. It did take a while, yeah.
So, they knew we were leaving somehow from the original place we left far before we got to town.
I want to say it was the man in the dark cloak that I saw. Somehow.
No,
but
no,
he just makes me paranoid. So that's just...
The only thing that could have beat us is a messenger that's not on foot.
Airborne?
Yeah. Is what I'm thinking. Obviously, I can be wrong, but, like, we didn't travel super fast, but we did travel through the night a couple times.
And we were in
pretty
the...
much constantly going.
Well, that and we were in
we
the woods, too,
time.
So it's not like we were paying attention if someone sent a messenger bird or something.
Yeah, but my thing is, like, the place we came from was pretty isolated, and no one generally left.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, my understanding on messenger birds, correct me if I'm wrong, is they generally return to where they're from, right? So, one person takes a bird from a pigeon or whatever from one location and goes with them somewhere else and then releases them with a message and then they return home.
Mm-hmm.
Is that generally correct?
Yeah.
So, what I'm thinking is, somehow, in the original town, we made enemies there, and they knew we were leaving.
Well, the mayor didn't like us much.
The mayor
original
the
one,
as well.
Not Bren or the blacksmith.
The mayor's dead, though. We found him on the side of the road.
Yeah, but he could have released the messenger bird before he died.
Yeah, but I don't think he honestly knew anything outside of his town, right? Like, he was pretty much lord of the little small hill, right? Like, no
yeah.
one had knowledge except the blacksmith that we found in that village.
Mm-hmm.
Well, from what it sounds like, that they want to interrogate one of us for some reason. I don't know anything. At least I don't think I do. Unless you guys.
The only interesting thing that happened was the cloak.
And the only thing I can suggest is that links us is, and I'll show my trinket with my letter. The only thing from the letter that we found here is the same wax seal as.
Yeah.
As that. But that's the only thing I can see that links us to anything.
I mean, I thought at first that it was Rowan chasing me and sending some pigmen or whatever after me, but I don't think it is anymore. I mean, she'd be sending the Lotuses after me, but not the Black Suns. I don't even know who these guys are.
I just think that it's worth trying to come up with a theory of who's chasing us. I don't think going back to the city is a good idea, because we're outnumbered. We're just going to get slaughtered.
Yeah, no.
But
the information's good.
I know we
need
the forest, but it's only a couple days through the forest to Umbermill, or... Is it Umbermill?
Yep.
It was only a couple days.
The forest wasn't the bad part of it.
Yeah.
No, it seemed to be pretty easy to travel.
Because this one's traveled more often with merchants and stuff.
Yeah, Umbermill and the city trade a lot.
There's probably people in Umbermill who are waiting for us, but...
Yeah, that's true. I'm just saying, like, I know you don't want to go back to where it all started, but... I don't know.
Can everybody give me an intelligence check? I just want to... If you get high enough, I'm just going to clarify a few things the guy said.
Ten.
16. Not bad for not very intelligent barbarian.
I got a 7.
Alright. So there's a few things I'll say because Almagar got high enough for things, just to clarify. So the guy did say that he was first hired a few 10 days ago. So it was prior to the shit that went on in the village with you guys. On top of that, he would have given the impression that it wasn't a hire to find you guys necessarily. Like, there could have been other tasks that they had been hired by these people to do. And then outside of that, regarding the village, yeah, you guys are right. The only thing that really happened was that kid, the only other person really interacted with that left the village often was the blacksmith. And not even often, I didn't think that often, I guess. But, and then the only person who left the village before you was the woman that you saved.
You saved a woman?
Maybe.
Yeah, she was in chains held by those guys.
Maybe that's the information that I'm looking for.
Kid.
Right.
And then when the magic kid killed everyone, he died.
Right, yeah.
And then she was pissed.
That was the other kid I killed. Kind of. I knew there was three, but I couldn't remember the other one earlier.
Yeah, so she was pissed because she came to collect him because she's from some order called, like, Beckers or something, and she went on the way after that. So I'm giving you guys this the benefit because we haven't played in so long. I know it's like tails have been put off.
It's all the magic.
But yeah, and I'm not saying that any of those are a key to what you're trying to figure out, but it's yeah, just so you're working with all the info.
It would make sense though that the information they're looking for is her whereabouts.
Yeah,
because she seemed pretty important. I do still want to go to that ivory tower that she went to.
Oh, where was that one of those?
I think that was to the north or something. Yeah?
I'd be up for checking that out.
Yeah, I'm really interested in that. And I mean, we'd probably be safe there, maybe? I mean, if they all have superpowers like this kid.
Okay, sounds like just walk into another shitstorm, however.
Is there anywhere where it's not shitstorm?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Let's see everywhere we go.
Pretty much, yeah.
Well, I don't think the game would progress as nicely if it was all like, oh, yeah, well, just throwing a party for you.
Well, I vote that we go north to this ivory tower. after the cart's fixed, rest on the way, and if there's any towns or anything, we'll stop, get some provisions and all that. I mean,
information, whatever, as
yeah,
we go.
Map.
map would be nice.
That's my vote, though. It's up to you guys. What else you want to do?
Yeah, all my guards gonna nod. And
keeps us away from going back into that city that's no good, and keeps us from going through the forest that we don't want to go back through, so.
And if we go east, we're just going to find another hostile city that's trying to kill us.
Or be thrown into a war, which I don't want to do.
Yeah. I don't think this is exactly our fight, so.
Yeah, I don't know anything about either of these cities, and I'm not involved in their war, so. Yeah, I'd kind of like to stay right out of this one, if at all possible.
And I'm kind of partial heading there pretty much any time, because, you know, I'm from the north.
Yeah, you're from the north too, aren't you? Yeah. Anyway, we'll find your tribe, and then we can bunk bed with them.
As I'm <I'll>
Can we stay in the guest house?
If there wasn't any tribe left.
maybe some got away. We don't know exactly what happened. We can be hopeful.
Well, I mean, I saw my family's bodies, but I'm sure there's other people in town.
I just, yeah, I meant from the tribe.
Your stone.
I was on my way down to the when that happened.
I think I was either right.
Well, because I don't know. I had planned, I thought we discussed, we never agreed upon it, but it was possibly like, yeah, we were down, or I was coming down because there was supposed to be family members getting married, and then when I showed up, our family was like murdered, and I'm like, I'm here for a wedding, and everyone's dead. What happened? Surprise! That's what that's what the invitation was the wedding invitation.
I was heading back to the wedding, too. I was out scouting and met up with you because I knew you were coming.
Yeah, you're meeting us.
Yeah.
And, well, yeah, we got a surprise getting back.
Yeah, so I've got a deep well of rage to feed my barbarian.
They'll let us in. I mean, what safer place to be than a bunch of people with magical abilities, which is not common in this world, right?
And I'm only really familiar with, like, the tribal magic we have, like, very, you know,
yeah, in fact, you guys can learn more from that.
Yeah, I don't think it's like magic missiles and stuff.
Yeah.
All these big, crazy, you know, big spells, but.
And I'm sure there's lots of loot that Antimates can kill people and steal from.
I don't know. I'm still a little hesitant. I'll go with you just because that's your vote and your leader, but I don't know. I don't trust anyone that can use magic. It's for witches.
Yeah, and that's where Antimans is as well, is after the witch incident, he's kind of like...
No, I don't trust it either. I'm just curious.
So who can we trust? Is there any type of stereotype that we can trust?
I just think it's the best bet, honestly. I don't know. It's either a war, or it's possibly new allies, right?
I like the idea.
I'm thinking
yeah.
North, but... As well.
Hey, if
I
we
mean,
could find some allies and some magic users or
like
organization, I think that'd
yeah.
be quite advantageous.
You guys are familiar with the region too, and also we don't really know too much about the north, so maybe there'll be something different out there, something better, right, than this shitstorm of people trying to kill us. So yeah, I guess we voted we're gonna go north.
Alright.
Alright.
Alex,
shit, now what do
we
do?
Yeah, I have all avenues planned.
Yeah.
All right, yeah,
it's not really an ivory tower. We get up to it, it's
yeah, exactly.
Obsidian.
I don't have
any
gold for us to follow, and we're like, oh no, squirrel.
My map really looks like a compass. It's got north, south, east, west. And on the west, it's like old story. East, like new story. North and south, say death. That's how you plan an open world campaign. In all seriousness, yeah, okay, so you guys are going to take off north. Are you leaving right now? Like, right this minute?
No, we want to make sure the cart's fully fixed, and
okay.
Then we'll leave, and whoever needs to rest in the cart, and we'll switch driving.
Okay. Alright, cool. That was the main thing that I was kind of wondering about there. Yeah, rest. So, as long as you guys are cool doing it in the cart, then so be it.
Phrasing, Alex. We're not doing nothing in the cart.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean, hey.
Well, don't be so heavy.
Who am I to judge? Not necessarily. You guys picked up the cart. You take it for a little like test drive on the path in front of you. It looks like the wheels are turning and it's making a little bit more noise than it might have normally. But otherwise, it's doing okay. And yeah,
the forest queen.
Yeah, it's not quite early morning, but so essentially what the area kind of looks like is, so you have to the west where you guys, not where you are, but you have like to the west forested area. The north heads up a ways, and I'm just, oh, by the way, talking from the perspective you guys can see when you're on the roads because you don't have a map, right? But to the north, it looks like a little more open plains, and then you can kind of see more of a grassland a little bit further on past the plains. So it looks like it's pretty flat, like a little hilly, but pretty flat. And far distance, you can see some mountains. South, it's similar, but it gets pretty hilly, and you can't really see past that. And then to the east, obviously, through the city, can't see a whole lot past the city, but from what you have kind of seen when you were in the city, and from what a bit sort of described to you about the next city on and that sort of thing, it looks like that ends up in some big body of water somewhere. The next city is considered coastal, and okay, that further on to the east. So that's kind of what the terrain in the area generally looks like without a map.
Okay. So it's flat and mountainous where we're going?
Yeah, so if you said north, it looks like flat land, and then you can't, it gets hilly, so you can't really see beyond that, but in the far distance, you can see some mountains.
Okay.
However, they're not like a solid wall, they kind of have like an opening, there's a big gap in them, and then they kind of go off to the east.
Cool.
So what is in that gap is under it.
Adventure!
We'll call it the side gap.
Test out the card. Who's going to be driving first? Who's going to be sleeping? What is that going to look like?
I personally should probably get some sleep sooner than later, so I'll ask if it's okay if I lay down there with you.
I'll, okay. I'll drive for while everyone rests, and then I'll take a nap afterwards.
Okay.
I'm used to not sleeping.
Alright. Cool. So, you guys take out of the forest then, and then you're just going to take the path north, stay on the road more or less?
Yep.
Gonna okay. Sleep with an axe in each hand.
So, as you kind of come out of the forest, you're going to see a little more chaos and panic in the city. Around the gate, which is now open again, people are traveling in and out of it. There's a big crowd gathered around one of the doorways near the fortress, probably where the guards' quarters are. There's like guards trying to push people back, and people like trying to get a view of what's going on. Yeah, it's
Oh, it's right when you need it.
Let you turn on north.
What if we had a bird that could just go fly and take a look?
And you keep traveling on. The sun is just kind of making its peak over some of the distant hills, so it's just becoming morning now. It's pretty cold still, and this day, as the sun rises a little more, it doesn't seem like it's getting a whole lot warmer. There's kind of frost in the air. Even as you're running through some of the grass, it looks like it's kind of squished down and frosted over a little bit. So it's definitely getting, you know, colder and closer to winter. But yeah, so you travel on for a couple days, swapping out. Okay, you have all rested, you've done your thing, you've taken turns.
While we're traveling, I kind of wanted to do something with cooking, because I have cutlery or chef tools or something. I just kind of wanted to, like, roll something, make some good food or something.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, 100%. You know, there's a lot of different ways to cook, so just take your highest ability score and just roll a dice and add that ability score to it, plus, you know.
Cooking with charisma.
Exactly. Hey, yeah, cooking with charisma. It's shit when you sell everybody on it. They think
yeah, that's true.
It was made with love, guys.
This is a French cuisine. If you can't appreciate it, it's because of your taste.
Ooh. 24.
Whatever you made, man, like, you whipped up some fruit, cheese, bread, meat stuff, and it was just delicious.
Getting good at this, guys.
Black Sunshade.
You know, in fact, I'm going to say this, because you guys had actually... So, last out-of-game thing here, sorry. I have to give you guys a huge, huge compliment, because for our, like, first couple sessions back, you guys know that I'm a stickler on role-playing, and you guys have just been, like, in it for both sessions, so that's awesome. So, that, plus, you know, a wonderful meal made by Pi, plus, you know, sun shining, and it's a little cold outside. I'm going to give you guys each... one inspiration you can kind of hang on to. So that is, as a refresher, a d6, and essentially you can roll that and add it to any roll that you want. It's a one-use thing, it's gone once you use it, but you can hang on to it, you can determine when you want to use it. And the way it works is that you can use it after you've rolled your dice, but before you hear the result. So if you, like, roll a d20, you get, like, a 5, and you're like, oh, fuck, I probably missed that, you can choose to roll it, but if you go, did I hit, and I tell you no, then you can't shoot d20.
Oh, okay.
So that's kind of the way that works.
Fair enough.
But I'm really inspired.
Alright. So anyways, yeah, so you guys are riding north, and for a change, you know, things are kind of nice. You can see the city off the distance for quite a ways. You know, you're kind of starting to go over some of the plains, a little bit of a lower hilly area. And in the distance, you see the city. But eventually, you kind of go up an incline, then it kind of dips down, and it does this a couple times descending. And you're now looking at just kind of hills behind you, and you can't really see that city anymore. And what's in front of you is revealed a little bit better. It's still some rolling hills, but you're at an altitude where you notice they actually keep descending. And what it looks like is, for quite a ways, it's, again, this plain hilly area, but then you actually get into a little bit of forest again. So it does end up being, there's a big patch of forest, and beyond that, almost gives you the impression there could be ocean. You can see, even from this distance, some water kind of shining beyond the forest. So clearly it's a very large body. And the mountains seem to kind of wrap around it almost, not completely though, and the water seems to push through in between the two mountain ranges there. So yeah, potentially more posts in this area. In the extreme distance, far away, you can also make out what appears to be a white tower standing kind of off of where you'd imagine the road to be, and there's this mountain face, and it's elevated and carved into the mountain face, and surrounding it are several layers of walls that kind of descend down the mountain, and you can see a sprawl of buildings and what appears to be some kind of a city at the base of said walls and said mountain. So yeah, that's kind of what that looks like.
Cool.
And again, just adding on, because, you know, it was nice out and we ate a good meal, I'm going to just start, like, singing one of my, you know, like, tribal songs or whatever. I assume
I'm going to whip out my drums as he does that and try and get some practice in on that, because I play well on drums, so yeah.
Yeah, just like a morale thing, and just like a little, you know, we're always not trying to be really loud, but, you know.
All right, so you guys do some jamming for a bit.
Oh, and I rolled a natural 20 for my drum playing.
Yeah. Someone brings all the boys to the
one-handed.
Sorry, what was that?
That broken collar, I'm going to toss that out somewhere along the road.
Okay. All right.
Oh. Is there any way that I would, or anyone would have, like, the knowledge or expertise to make JoJo a, like, armor out of that black leather? Like, just kind of makeshift it somehow? Or would I have to go to, like, a blacksmith or something?
Does anyone have a background in kind of leatherworking or blacksmithing or anything else along those lines? So, I mean, odds are, you know, like, yeah, so you guys have soldier backgrounds, and you have, like, kind of village backgrounds, yeah. You, and being barbarian stuff, you probably have a okay knowledge to make some rudimentary stuff from that leather, yeah. It's not going to be great, though.
Yeah.
If you want something professionally done, I mean, you want to go to some kind of leather. But, yeah, you could get something rudimentary for sure, like these together.
Okay. Yeah, maybe work on that, I guess, on the way as well.
Okay. Cool. Alright. So, you guys continue traveling. Now, I do want to emphasize that although you see this tower, you're probably guesstimating that you've got potentially a month worth of travel ahead of you to get there. Like, it's... The only reason you're seeing it is because we're literally
in
Saskatchewan now.
But is this tower, like... I mean, okay, so it's flat. We get that. But, I'm assuming if we can see in its, like, distance a month away, this is, like, a fairly large tower then, eh?
It's huge. Like, it's massive. Okay. That is a big mountain that it's carved into, and it is probably half the height of said mountain.
Oh, okay.
So it's just
wow. Okay,
massive.
So this is just, like, a feat in itself, just looking at it, okay.
Yeah.
Well, the good thing is they'll see us coming for several weeks.
Hey, we got some visitors. We should prepare a banquet in a few months.
We're going to send some parties to kill them before they get close.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You said there was, like, an ocean or something on the way?
So it looks like that mountain is kind of... So if you were to follow the path you guys are on just straight, assuming it goes straight, you'd eventually end up in the ocean. So let's pretend, like, the path goes all the way to the ocean. And kind of off to the right of the ocean is kind of a mountain range, and in that mountain range is where that tower is carved into. So the tower could almost be described as coastal. Like, the city that's at the base of the mountain is probably on the ocean, but the tower itself is within the mountain.
Okay. We should maybe stop by the body of water, and you can go fishing.
I have a fishing tackle and stuff. I can fish, and when we set up camp, I also have a hunter's trap. I can set up stuff for that too, so I can, along the way, not only forage for food, but we can actually get some decent game as well.
Yeah.
Okay, awesome. So yeah, essentially, you guys are traveling, and night falls, you've still got a lot of journey ahead of you, and you're starting to level out a little bit more of where that forest was. So you're not close to the forest yet, you still probably got a bit of travel to get there, but so you're on this kind of same level, and because of that, the tower and, like, the city and stuff, now you're not in an elevation above it so much, or the trees are in your way, you can't really see it, you can see kind of the tip of the tower because it's so tall. But now the trees are higher and along the same path as you. You can no longer see the ocean city there.
When we get to, like, the forest, I think we should take some time and actually collect some wood that would be easy to burn and stuff for that, so we can have a decent fire without having to worry about cutting up a whole bunch of logs and such.
Mm-hmm.
Although I know my cousin here has the tools to get the job done. If you don't have to make so much noise to scare away all the game, just grab the loose brush that's around here would be better.
Okay. Yeah, the journey to the forest is still probably at least a couple days away, so you won't be able to get to the edge quite yet. So yeah, if you can scatter some things around there's bushes and, like, small trees and that kind of shit in the area before the forest too, so you can definitely grab some resources and materials.
Yeah, I would like
to see any kind of settlement or farm or
no,
cabin.
Yeah, oddly enough, no.
While we're traveling, I'd like to keep an eye out for any birds in the sky that might be flying around too.
Okay, definitely. Yeah, so you've definitely noticed birds. There's been many, many kinds. Some seem hunting, others not. But yeah, many different types, and there are definitely a few that, while you don't know the region, may look a little out of place.
Hmm. Somebody's watching you.
So, nice getting close. You guys are kind of getting to the end of probably your trail. I'm assuming you're stopping to camp for the night, right?
Yeah.
Okay. And you get to a point now where you're kind of a little, you've come out of a cleft of a hill, and you can actually see on the distance, kind of to the east a little bit, there is what appears to be a small farming settlement. There might be, a few buildings on kind of a large farm in the area. They're probably a few hours ride away still. If you want to approach them, you definitely can. But, yeah, you can try a little bit longer. But otherwise, yeah, it's a starry night. Moon is out. Clear skies. And it kind of just appears to be you guys and the open plains for the moment.
And it's not that we haven't seen anyone else on this trail. No one else is...
Not a person. Not a soul.
You said there's a farm on the way?
Couple hours.
There's kind of a farm a little bit deviated off of the path to the east, yeah.
I don't think we're going to find a map or anything.
I'd say just go camp here. Last time we stayed at a farm, those goats weren't goats in there.
Not the goats.
You're supposed to be sleeping in their barn. What's the worst thing that could happen?
Right?
And is it getting fairly cool at night? Should we be having fires, or can we get away with not having them?
You could probably get away with getting close to each other and wearing some blankets. I don't know what kind of materials you guys have, if you have winter clothing or winter vision. If you do, you're probably okay. If not, yeah, probably fire time pretty soon.
Mm. Have traveler's clothes and a bedroll and blanket.
Yeah, so you're probably okay to keep warm for the next little bit, but I mean... Winter is coming. Okay. So are you guys going to kind of just stop here off the edge of the road and camp then?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Was there... Oh, yeah, we probably haven't salvaged any alcohol in the cart, eh? Pretty much everything was lost.
I don't know. Did someone grab a cask? Or...
No.
No one grabbed one. However... There was one that was sitting behind the chain chests that managed to stay on board. So you guys do have a small cask of meat.
Okay. I'm going to just remember the bottle I found out at the little farmhouse back when we had our first encounter.
Yep.
I think it might have even been in... Yeah, anyway. It's... Yeah, bottle homebrew didn't look like anything special at all, but I'm going to open it up and just smell it and maybe give it the tiniest taste to see if it's drinkable.
Perhaps not the finest liquor you've ever had, but you know what? For something brewed in probably a big barrel in somebody's farm, it's not terrible either.
Okay. I'll take a swig and just pass over to Maple.
I'll take a swig.
So I figure we're... What's that?
I said, I'll take a swig, yeah. I'm not even going to question what's in there.
Yeah.
Oh, while we get camp set up, I'm going to set up my hunting trap in hopes to maybe catch a rabbit or something along the way.
Sure.
But after that, and after we get kind of settled, I do think we should make just a small little fire. At least we have something burning. I can't see in the dark, so if we are going to be staying kind of on the road, I know it kind of lets everyone else know that we're here, but...
I was going to make a fire anyway. I wanted to try cooking with the liquor this time.
Well, I was going to say, too, if we're going to make a fire, there's some light. I would like to try and have another look at that large book in that unknown language.
Okay. Yeah, sure.
8 this time.
Okay.
But I'll take more time setting up the trap than...
It's a little more moldy now.
Yeah, you try and add a little bit to what you did before. Maybe the liquor's a little overpowering, but hey, it still warms the blood, right? So...
You're cooking for two barbarians. Like, eh, how can you go wrong? Just add more alcohol, right?
Yeah. Okay, cool. So you want to analyze that book.
Just for the sake of my background, I do know Dwarvish and Gnome because I did trading with them, but that's all I have for knowledge outside of common.
Yeah, 100%. Okay. So this, the reason why, when you guys found this book, I was pretty adamant about none of you guys knowing it, is this is like in a script that just seems very, very foreign. A lot of letters, like common, is based off of a mix of Elvish and Dwarven. A lot of people know that. Although those races, you know, aren't very common in today's world, they obviously exist. They know that, like, characters are based off of the old Dwarven patterns, that sort of thing. And a lot of the spoken word is based off of Elvish. So there's, like, even if you don't know language, there's similarities you can pick up. This is, like, I guess the best way I can describe it in like a real world context would be like English to Japanese kind of thing. Like it's just drastically
gibberish.
Different.
Yeah.
Yeah. So like the symbols don't make sense, you're not sure. It almost looks like the lines may be going in columns instead of across the page.
Okay. On further inspection, since I clearly don't understand any of this, I want to look at the materials it's made with. So, like, the type of paper, if I can discern anything from the pigments of the ink, if it actually was ink that was written. Like, you know, little things like that. Like, I know I'm not proficient in anything like this, but I'm just trying to see if, like, maybe I can figure out, like, a region of an area or something that this may have actually came from or, you know, something of that sort.
You don't have, like, investigator survival or anything else?
I'm proficient in survival, and I got, one in investigate.
Okay. Your survival is probably better, though, I would imagine, overall.
No, because I have no wisdom.
Oh, okay.
My investigation has one, my wisdom is zero, so...
give me an investigate, then. 15,
16, 17 total.
So... this is a finely crafted book. You could probably sell it to somebody that doesn't understand it for a decent amount of money if they were a scholar interested in this kind of thing. As far as region, it's tough to tell. Like I said, you've never really seen something like this before. But you can only guess, like in like a really on the level of kind of child fairy tale kind of guess, would be there are supposedly these people way to the south that are rumored to have, like, really strange languages and really strange speech and that sort of thing. And they're supposed to be a very learned people, so they like books and they like knowledge and that sort of thing. So, you know, perhaps it's those guys. Now, how it made its way up here, who knows? Because it's not common. But yeah, it's definitely, like, as far as books go, kind of a gem, I'd say. So finally bound. Leather, nice paper, thick paper, made of probably material that even as barbarian, like factoring in your survival a little bit to that, I know it's an investigate check, but most paper is made sometimes from hides of animals, depending on the quality of it, and sometimes it can be made of like very, very compressed wood. This is odd. It's almost like silky feeling. Like it's not cloth, but it's a very different kind of feeling. It's not oily either, but yeah. It just has the impression of wealth kind of all around
baby
it.
Baby skin.
Baby skin, yeah. Tightened baby skin. Cool. Yeah, so you investigate the book, you guys have a meal, you have some drinks. So who's going to be doing what for watch?
Well, I can sit for a while. I can take the first watch.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, Jojo will take the second one, I guess. So, Almagar, I guess you'll take the watch, and then he can crash when we leave.
Yeah, I don't even mind. I can sleep tomorrow on the cart as we go, or whatever.
Okay.
I can sit with the dogs and keep the fire going.
Okay. Alright, so the rest of you are going to sleep then while Almagar takes watch?
Yeah.
Okay.
I will make sure I've collected enough firewood for like two. Again, just a smaller fire just to keep.
Yeah, you can definitely scrounge from, again, the bushes. There's some small trees, so you can take branches or, you know, you can pull trunks from really want, but they're, you know, probably like that thick around. Kind of thing. So yeah, there's.
Mm-hmm.
There's...
I'm going to sleep underneath the cart.
Okay. Alright. So.
I'm going to keep an eye on the horses too, because I know that horses and dogs both can have pretty good senses, so. Just watch for their. Yeah.
Definitely. So, you're up for a couple hours, and then it's pretty quiet. You hear some animals that you're not really familiar with off the distance. They don't sound necessarily threatening, but, you know, like, weird kind of chirping or, like, barking's not a good example, but, like, you know, strange noises in the night. There are some wolves, definitely, that you hear as well. They don't have to sound like they're sounding coming from the forest. They're kind of in the area, but as they're pinging each other with their howls, it doesn't seem like they've picked up too much on you guys, if they're even interested at all, because the howls just kind of go off the distance after probably about half an hour. What really strikes your interest is while you're sitting out in the night, everything's quiet until you hear a scream from the farm kind of off to the east. And only a few minutes
after told you that, we didn't want to go there for the night.
After only a few minutes after that scream, one of the buildings go up in flames. And moments after that building's up in flames, you see a troop riding horses just powering down from the farm in your guys' general direction.
Okay.
As you look at them, can you actually give me an intelligence check?
I'd rather do wisdom. Oh, what about my turn? Okay. Oh! With all the bonuses that I gave, I'll be 5.
Awesome. You're not sure who these guys are. However, the ground is now shaking from just the full gallop of their horses. The rest of you easily wake up from this noise. The dogs are starting to bark. The horses are
starting. I was going to say, I would have, the moment I saw them, even like that, I would have, even with the first house going up, I would have put the fire out, kind of, and then started trying to wake people up. Cause...
Sure, so yeah, so you pat out the fire, wake people up. So can everybody else, anyone that's obviously going to look at the thing Almagar's pointing at, can the rest of you guys give me intelligence checks, please?
They're coming fast, and there's lots of them. That's all I do.
18.
19.
Jordan's like, hey, well, that guy's name is Steve, and that guy's not.
Alright, no,
they're
so,
riding Steve. Steve is always the evil horse.
So, Maple, you can definitely identify at least who these guys, who you think these guys are. As they're riding, notice gray cloaks kind of billowing off their shoulders. These are the same people that came to collect or had that female magic user in chains.
Oh, well, I'll straight up let everyone know that right away.
Yeah, and they seem to be on a beeline path.
Just want to say, as we're, like, Elgmar's putting out the fire, we're waking up, I'm going to quickly go run and grab my hunting trap and pull that in and just kind of, like, pack up.
Okay. Awesome.
Yeah.
Some little pitch to grab.
I'm not wasting my hunting trap. Forget that nonsense.
And I think that's where we'll end it tonight.